Jesus' death, burial, and resurrection for all our sins, and call upon him. For whosoever shall call upon the name of the Lord Jesus shall be saved. Be a whosoever. It doesn't matter what you have done. It doesn't matter how many bad things you have done. If you go to Jesus, in truth, he will accept you because he loved you. He made you. He knows you better than you know yourselves. Inside your body is your spirit. That spirit one day will leave your body and will go to one of two places, heaven or hell. Jesus wants you in heaven, and it's only requiring you to believe. Believe. He made it so simple. Simple enough for a two-year-old child to understand that Christ died for our sins according to the scriptures. He was buried and he rose again from the dead on the third day, that if you shall confess with your mouth the Lord Jesus and shall believe in your heart that God has raised him from the dead, you will be saved. Save yourselves. The tribulation period is about to start when the Antichrist shall reign on the earth, and he will cause all to receive a mark in their right hands or in their foreheads. And without the mark, nobody shall be able to buy or sell. The rapture of the church is upon us. Go and watch the film Left Behind by Nicolas Cage. That shows you what is about to happen. A great vanishing of many people is about to happen. The saints, all born-again believers, will be caught up to heaven in a twinkling of the eye. And then will start the great tribulation when the Antichrist will reign. And you don't want to be here for that. You don't have to be here for that. The only requirement for you to know your eternal destination is heaven is to believe the good news, which is that Jesus died for us on the cross to pay the penalty in full for all our sins, past, present, and future. He was buried and he rose again from the dead on the third day. That if you shall confess with your mouth the Lord Jesus and shall believe in your heart that God raised him from the dead, you will be saved. The hour is very, very late. We have come to tell you that there is very good news, that Jesus Christ is the way, the truth, and the life, and that if you believe on his death, burial, and resurrection, you will be saved with everlasting life. You will be taken up to heaven in the rapture. Do not be left behind. God wants none of you to be left behind for what is coming upon this world. The sun is shining. The weather is nice. That can change overnight, and it will. There's a great tribulation about to start on this world, and war the likes of this world has never seen before. You do not have to be here for that. That's if you will believe the simple good news, which is that Christ died for us. He paid the penalty in full on the cross for all our sins. He was buried and rose again on the third day. That's the good news. That's the gospel of your salvation. That if you shall confess with your mouth the Lord Jesus and shall believe in your heart that God has raised him from the dead, you will be saved. For whosoever shall call upon the name of the Lord Jesus shall be saved. Save yourselves. Jesus is coming. He loves you. God bless you, York. Jesus loves every one of you. He's given you free will. Will you accept the very one who can save your soul and give you everlasting life? Or will you reject him? Satan the thief comes not but for to steal, to kill, and to destroy. Jesus Christ has come that we might have life, and that we might have it more abundantly. That if you shall confess Jesus Christ with your mouth and believe in your heart that God raised him from the dead, you will be saved. For whosoever shall call upon the name of the Lord Jesus shall be saved. Jesus loves you, York. God bless you all. Jesus loves every single one of you. He's given you free will. He wants you to accept his gift of everlasting life by believing on what he did for us on the cross. He was crucified for all our sins. He was buried and rose again on the third day. That if you shall confess with your mouth the Lord Jesus and shall believe in your heart that God has raised him from the dead, you will be saved. Hurry up, please. Jesus is coming. We have got hours before he descends from heaven with a shout, with the voice of the archangel and the trumpet of God. And the dead in Christ will rise first. Then we which are alive and remain shall be caught up together with them in the clouds to meet the Lord Jesus in the air. And then will start the great tribulation. You don't need to be here for that. Call upon the name of Jesus Christ and you will be saved. He's not asking you to be religious. He's only asking that you would receive by believing. Receive his gift of everlasting life by believing the good news. That Jesus has already paid the debt for all our sins on the cross. He was buried and rose again on the third day. If you believe that truly in your hearts and call upon it, you will be saved. It doesn't matter what you have done, all can be saved. For whosoever shall call upon the name of the Lord Jesus shall be saved. Jesus did not send his son into the world to condemn the world, but that the world through him might be saved. Jesus said, I am the way, I am the truth, and I am the life. There is no other name under heaven given amongst men by which we might be saved. Jesus, he said, I am the door. By me, if any man shall enter in, he shall be saved. Save yourselves. You have a choice. You don't have to go down to hell. You can go to heaven by simply believing on what Jesus did for us on the cross. His death, his burial, and his resurrection for all our sins. And call upon him, and you will be saved.